We are at something new here inside the big expo building. It's called Beaumont Honey. Not Vermont honey, but Beaumont honey. And it's quite a booth here. We've got some honey products over there, but actually a live demonstration of some of the bees. And we're joined by Paul Pigeon with Beaumont Honey. Paul, good to be with you on NBC5. And first of all, this is fascinating to look at. Can you tell the people at home what we're looking at here?
So we have an observation hive here. And what I do is I stick in 5 frames on the bottom, and they're filled with honey, brood, and resources for this top frame. So we have put the queen up here. And this bottom gate keeps her up because she's too big to go below. And she's rolling, as you can see, she's laying up brood throughout this frame. And the main reason is we want people to learn. They want to see the queen. You know, when you come to see a hive, you want to see the queen. So I marked her red, and that tells me what year she was born. And it gives me a good idea on how long she'll live, you know, as I monitor her.
So everyone, I think, knows that this kind of work has become more difficult in recent years. What do you think's going on?
We have a lot of issues with varroa mites. The mite actually clings onto our bees, and it can get inside of our brood, and it weakens our bees and causes diseases. And we have such long winters that it causes collapsing hives. And it's becoming a big issue. It's been an issue for quite a while. So I know that they're working on better treatments, and we hope that they can get them soon, because it's hard on the bees. But as beekeepers, we need to step up, and we watch our bees as best we can to take care of them.
What's been your favorite thing of the fair here with your new exhibit this year? Favorite part of the fair so far this year?
I love talking to people about bees. Honestly, I like honey, but I love bees. And we have been getting so many different, you know, hobbyist beekeepers, or used to be beekeepers, that are, you know, they were discouraged. And what I tell them is, you know, you can't judge your first year on your entire beekeeping, you know, experience. You know, you should always try again. Yeah. And I mean, I lost my bees the first year, I lost my bees the second year, but I learned the tricks, and I'm still learning every year. Like, bees adapt, and they're just phenomenal. I love bees.
Well, Paul, thank you for talking with us on NBC5, and good luck. Well,